Cheers, this is Little Dragon for Little Dragon's production with a special episode of Celtic Warfare Episode 2. So, today we're going to talk about the Gladius, but this time, as with the Celtic Broadsword, we're not going to talk about its battlefield use, but when it was used by civilians. Let me just put down this Celtic Dress Sword, so you don't get confused. Right now, I can't actually put it down, but it will be. So, let's just say I am a rich senate, or actually, even better, I am a lifeguard. So I try to protect a senate or a rich man or anything like that. And suddenly somebody shows up and wants to attack him. I don't have the shield right now with me. We are just walking around. I'm just there to look big, but somebody don't think I look big enough. So I have to pull this up, the Gladius. But then what? We don't have many sources on that, actually, but I think I have the answer. If I put down this again, that worked better. We have the Celtic long knife. You have it a bit like this, and then you, when you attack, you move around quickly. So this can be used with the shield, same techniques, and without a shield. So going back to the actual weapon again, the Gladius, you have the battlefield techniques, but then you have the actual street techniques when it comes to bigger knives and so on. And I think that's how you would use it. You would keep it at an angle like this, not like when you have a shield like this. So you could thrust like that, but while you keep it at the angle, you could cut, and you can, I would argue that you would hold yourself to the throw thrust. It's not actually that you're throw, it's not like the sword casting blow, because the only thing you do is to bend your wrist. You're not actually letting the sword forward. So you, like that. So the thing is, when you use this weapon, I think that you would need to move around quickly as usual. But the other thing is to use more chopping motions as well, and try to get towards the belly and grappling. You can also use the pommel a lot more to maybe, alright, you attack, I block, hit, cut, thrust. So, further in this video now, we're going to talk about theories behind that and so on, and look at some pictures as well. So, let's continue with that. As we know, the Gladius is mainly used, or was mainly used, on the battlefield and by gladiators as well as legionaries. So, the thing is that it's supposed to be used with a shield. But there are some situations, like when you are in your civilian clothes, where you can't wield a shield, where you might actually have a Gladius. And these are the actual situations we're talking about right now, because as you can see here, the clothings that were used by civilians and even the Senate are very thin. You don't have a very thick clothing. It's not used for defense or anything like that, just for everyday life. And here you supposedly can see a Roman bodyguard, or maybe a town's guard, I don't know exactly. But he wields the Gladius and civilian clothes without a shield. This might be actually a famous person even, or a senate or anything like that. And the Gladius could be used as a tool of personal defense. But the thing is, if you're going to use it as a tool of personal defense, the way of fighting with it would change rapidly, because you don't have any type of shield. And as you don't have any type of shield, this means that you have to rely completely on the timing and the fact that you have to use the weapon differently. And as you can see here, there are many problems if you're going to fight against somebody that are using the same weapon or a completely different weapon. So, and if somebody uses a shield, you have big problems. If you use the techniques that are used in Battlefield. So going back to the clothing, you can actually see right here, if you look back at the clothing, that you couldn't even rely on the clothing. In medieval time, you could wield thick clothing, somewhat gambeson-like clothing to protect yourself. But in this time, you had to rely on your timing, your speed, and the fact that you had to be the first one to strike, to surprise your opponent. But was this a main issue? I would say that it might have been, but we don't know really much about this. We know that the Gladius was used to execute criminals, and this was done by thrusting through the shoulder down to the heart, which made them bleed to death. So we know that, but the problem is when it comes to civilian battles or fighting or martial art, we don't know really much. So my theory, through testing this against other people, is simply that it would be used more like a bigger knife, so many short thrusts, many chopping motions, draw cuts and so on, and try to be quick and get as close towards your opponent and try to move in quickly, move out quickly, more surprises than you would use on the battlefield. So it's more about who hits first, who threw the stone first. So it's as simple as that, but it's completely different when the opponent uses a shield as well, even if it's a small shield. It's really hard to fight against them. It could work, but it's more about timing and so on, and you have to think about the fact that the shield can be used as a weapon. And this is something that many people forget. Even a small shield hurts if you hit it, get hit by it right in the face. I would argue that most people that did not have a shield would back off, or at least try to attack them by surprise. So, in conclusion, many things that you use on the battlefield you could use in the situation where you are a civilian using a Gladius. So this can be used if you want to make a dual scenario, or a scenario where you are a Roman that is getting robbed and you are going to fight that way, which actually is partially what Scholar Gladiatore is talking about when it comes to making goals in HEMA. You can actually make that a goal and then try to move around, because then you realize which techniques works the best. So yeah, that's all for today. Thank you for watching, like, comment and subscribe, and as always, have a nice day. Cheers.